Hi, I'm David Croteau, and I want to give you a more detailed explanation of Columbia Biblical Seminary's Ph.D. program and our modified European model. In the first year of the program, you're going to start off with a course called Issues and Methods. Now, if you're in biblical studies, it's Issues and Methods in Biblical Studies. If you're in theological studies, Issues and Methods in Theological Studies. And if you're in practical theology, it's Issues and Methods in Practical Theology. So in this course, you're going to start off and talk about the different issues in your field of study. And you'll be guided through a fully online course through the different topics that need to be understood by someone who has a PhD in your area of discipline. The second half of the course is going to deal with methodology. And in that, you're going to talk about the different methodologies that are used in your field of study. So when it comes to issues, one of the papers you'll produce will be precedent research, the history of research of your dissertation topic. That can feed right into your dissertation if you do it well. The second one on methodology can help you understand and finalize what methodology you want to use when you're writing your dissertation. The second course we offer is called Teaching, Learning, and Course Design. What we have found is that most students who go through a PhD program never take a course on how to teach. They take courses on research, they take a lot of content courses, but never about how to teach. And most of us, when we get our PhD and get a job teaching somewhere, spend most of our time teaching, not researching and writing. So we wanted to make up for that gap in education and offer a course on how to teach. So in this course, you will take a pause from writing on your dissertation. You'll take a course on teaching, where you'll learn the different principles for being an effective communicator and teacher. The next part of the course will be on learning, the different styles of learning that your students might have. And then you will learn how to do a course design. When I got my first job teaching, a few months later, before I started teaching, they asked me to produce 6 syllabi for my classes that next semester. Well, I had never actually written a syllabus before. So I had to start from round one and figure out how to write a syllabus and what other components necessary in a syllabus on the fly after I had finished my program, like 2 months before I was ready to start teaching in my first job. We want to prepare you for that ahead of time. The third course you'll take in the first summer of your first year is called Dissertation Proposal. And in this course, you will write your dissertation proposal, be guided through a process to write your dissertation proposal, and you will actually create a schedule for how you want to write your dissertation, a timeline, when you want to have certain things done. So your whole program now is laid out before you. So that's the first year of the dissertation program. In the second year, you will spend 18 hours in research. You will be assigned to a PhD mentor. You will communicate with them if you're a full-time student twice a month, and if you're a part-time student once a month. And that communication needs to be substantial, not just an email here or there. It could be a phone call, it could be a video conference, or if you live near the mentor, you can meet face-to-face. In these meetings with your mentor, you will primarily be focusing on the research of your dissertation. He will be pointing out maybe articles or books or chapters that you're missing or flaws in your argumentation as you're dialoguing with him. But he'll also have access to a document called Foundational Knowledge. And this is a document created by the faculty at Columbia Biblical Seminary that lays out the basic foundational knowledge that you should have in your area of discipline. And he will just talk with you about the different issues in your discipline and make sure you're knowledgeable on these issues. Now, if you're not, he will then create some sort of assignment for you to get up to speed. It might be just reading a couple chapters here or there, or creating a bibliography, or just saying in 2 weeks when we talk about this again, make sure you're up to speed. And so in year two, you're researching. You're doing all the research you can do for your dissertation. In year three, it's broken into two parts. Part one is the writing of the dissertation. This will take place over 2 semesters, where you will write your dissertation, you will write sample chapters, you will turn them into the PhD mentor, and he will give you feedback. Once the dissertation mentor and the PhD program director and the student believes that you're ready to defend the dissertation, then it will go to a committee, with three PhDs who will then read through your dissertation and you will have to defend it. And that will be in the summer of your third year, where you will defend your dissertation before this committee. So that's how our modified European model program accomplishes all the outcomes we think that you need to be a successful academic, researcher, and teacher.